is correct.
It's always very different. Recently, I've been called to that bed in the food here, which was very good. Thank you very much. I will be very brief because, first of all, it's late. And then, a lot has been said already. I don't want to be repetitive and say the same thing. I try to be original. I thank very much Wolfgang for having expressed a few concepts that I also, from his personal point of view, that I also agree with. We are always, I cannot say attacked, but criticized not to be brave, which maybe is true, because maybe more things can be done. But believe me, in the circumstances where the European policy develops, we really do a lot. I think that everybody has to understand that drugs policy is not something which is in the hands of the European Union as such. Drugs policy is in the hands of 28 member states that constitute a range of opposite positions, going from a very traditional approach to more liberal approach, and all the nuances between that. So, and they are the responsible bodies. I mean, they create and develop the policy is in their hands. So while we have been successful, I would say, I don't know if we have been successful using the indicators, the concrete indicators of, let's say, reducing drugs or reducing the harms and so on. The EMCDDA tells us that we have been successful in that, or at least in part of that. I think we have been successful from a policy point of view, because we have been able to make the member states so different between them, converging in a set of important principles. The principles that have been enumerated already by the MCDDA, but I like to repeat. First of all, the idea that the drug is a health question, preliminary. This is what we think in Europe, and I think that even the most traditional, let me use this term, countries already understand this issue. Secondly, that in this policy, as in all the other policies that the European Union treats in one way or the other, human rights and fundamental rights are in the center of our preoccupation. The European Union is founded on that principles, so the European Union defends that principles in every circumstances and every place, and for every kind of policy we are called to work. So the respect of human rights and all that is a founding principle of our drug policy as of all other policies of the European Union. Then the balanced approach. That being said, the balanced approach, you know better than me what is it. I mean, the idea that the supply reduction interventions have the same dignity and the same importance that demand reduction interventions. Personally, I think that the best